Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the Philippines. Yeah, I wanted to come on and make another video. It's kind of a, people have a hard time, brothers and sisters, understanding that it's like this. When we hear something that's kind of negative or kind of bad from the Lord, lots of people get focused on the negative without accentuating the positive. And really what we need to do is always focus on the Lord. No matter what we go through, what kind of valley is, even as it says in the 23rd Psalm, the most famous Psalm in the Bible, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Why? Because thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. So the Lord is with us even in the valley. There's I guess it's a Southern gospel song, because I don't listen to Southern gospel, but I like this one song. I think it's by the McCameys. It's called Even the Valley is Higher Ground. It's I don't know if I can sing it. Even the valley is higher ground. Satan can't touch me where God's love abounds. There is not a place where his hand cannot reach down. Even the valley is higher ground. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I wanted to talk to you about what the Lord had told me a couple of days ago. I didn't mention it in the videos because the Lord didn't lead me to the last two videos I made. And also, as I said, the problem with people is they cannot take some bad news and give it back to the Lord in praise. I mean, that's the problem with most people. You know, that's the secret to overcoming the enemy. That's the secret to revival. That's the secret to being a Christian, is in all things, as it says, in everything, you know, give thanks to the Lord. As they say, not for everything, but in everything, every situation, wherever you may find yourself, way in the valley or on the top of the mountain, give God all the glory. Hallelujah. For who was and is to come. Hallelujah. He is great, wonderful, mighty counselor. Glory to God the Father. Hallelujah. He is our Lord and our God. Hallelujah. Jesus, the Messiah, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Christ, the Son of the of David. Hallelujah. The bright morning star, the root and offspring of David. Hallelujah. Bless his holy name. Righteous is his name. Worthy is his name. Holy is his name. Great is his name. Hallelujah. Let the earth magnify. Let the earth glorify. Let the world exalt the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God. And I want to give you, before I give you the word that the Lord gave me, I want to give you something else. I was just praying. You know how the Lord is. He shows me things I would have never thought of in a million years. Or, you know, maybe in a million years I would have thought of it, but I wouldn't have thought of it on my own anytime soon. And, you know, my father-in-law just died on the 7th of March. And anyway, you know, it just came into my mind about my father-in-law. And then I saw this bride. And then the Lord was like asking me, well, like, or telling me, well, to the bride, the father is our father-in-law. The Jesus' father, even though we are adopted children of God through Abraham, God is our father-in-law. So in that way, for me, you know, my father-in-law or your father-in-law, if you have an earthly father-in-law, is a type of God the Father for those who are members of the bride. Now that is something I would never have thought of, never even considered in my mind. So I thank God for the fact that he wants us to, and the way the Lord uses me, and if we seek him, he will show us things from his perspective and show us things from a new way of seeing things that we would never see in our flesh. So praise God for that little nugget of deep thought. You know, it's a deep thought, and it's not by Jack Handy, for those who were used to watch TV on Saturday night way back in those days there. Anyway, brothers and sisters, the Lord had given me a pretty negative word, or, you know, a bad thing is coming. And, you know, I've messaged it to two or three people. I told my wife. And I told the house mom and dad and of the orphanage. And I told a couple of people on YouTube who I've messaged with. and the Lord has just compelled me to share it now. Like I said, he didn't tell me to make it in those last two videos that I made earlier, just this one. So he compelled me to come on here and make this video. Now, after I've done all that joyful stuff, just to show you that in the midst of no matter what, God is with us, brothers and sisters. Can you understand that? Lots of times people hear something negative and they just go off the deep end. Hey, where's your faith? But you know, great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. As I love to keep, you know, the Lord keeps leading me to sing that song, you know, the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercy never comes to an end. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. Great is thy faithfulness. His mercies are new every morning. That's from the Bible. Lots of those songs are straight out of the Bible. And that is an example of one. God is with us. That yea, though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Why? Because thou art with me. Psalm 23. Listen, brothers and sisters, he is a good shepherd. That's the 23rd Psalm. Is the Lord is my shepherd, right? I shall not want. This is the word that the Lord gave me. World War III is upon you. Get your house in order. That's what the Lord told me. Now, because, you know, my wife still has relatives that are not Christian that I need to deal with. I have lots of relatives who are not Christian. I've tried to deal with them, but some of my wife's relatives I have not evangelized too much. Not directly. And so I need to hurry up and do that. And need to, you know, not waste any time having any kind of, you know, arguments or disagreements with my wife or anybody. And focus on, you know, going forward with the Lord. But that's not just for me. It's for all of you guys, too. And then the Lord told me, I heard like a, you know, and I heard this expression, you know, for whom the bell tolls. You know, like there's a book or whatever, for whom the bell tolls. And I heard like a bell, you know, like I used to live in Germany when I was in the army for 7 years. And lots of those places, you know, they have these big church towers. And they ring on a regular basis. And then it used to be that in the way in the States back in the old days. You know, in a town, they would have the bell and it would ring, you know, like a grandfather clock. How many times it would chime for every hour, right? So I heard the, you know, like a chimes or, you know, like a, I guess a church bell ringing. But like ding, 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 like for the time. And it's 12 times. And then I heard, it is the midnight hour. It is the midnight hour. And then I heard the Bible verse from Matthew chapter 25. And this is a good part, you know, for the wise virgins and the foolish virgins, the 10 virgins parable that the Lord Jesus Christ told. And in that parable, the Lord said, and at the midnight hour, the cry rang out, behold, the bridegroom cometh. You know, so that was the warning. Boom, it's time for the rapture. The bridegroom is coming for his bride. So we can go meet the father-in-law. The father of the bride, the father, our heavenly father, through our adoption as Christians, through Abraham, we're adopted children of God. But as the bride, as the church, as the bride of Christ, we're, you know, God is our father-in-law in that way that, it, like as I said, I never thought about that until just tonight, as the Lord had showed me that. Probably more so because my father-in-law just died, my earthly father-in-law. Anyway, so here's the point, brothers and sisters. You keep, you know, there's always people, even in the secular world, you know, this, you know, they have that, there's some scientists have some kind of clock, you know, so many minutes to midnight, and they'll say, oh, it's 5 minutes till midnight, it's 11:59, 1 minute till midnight, all that kind of stuff. And I think, I'm sure I've mentioned that in videos before, that we're 10, you know, just seconds before midnight. But the Lord said, the clock, you know, I heard the clock striking. And I heard the expression, for whom the bell tolls. And then I heard, this is the midnight hour. Not 11:59. This is the midnight hour. And in the midnight hour, the Lord is coming for his bride. And I'm just reminded of something else. There's a song, and it's for those people that will be here in the tribulation. Those people that are ready to celebrate the kingdom of the Antichrist. It's a rock song, or, you know, actually it's an old blues song, you know, I'll wait till the midnight hour. wait till the midnight hour when your love comes to town, or whatever it is, something like that, when your love comes down. But it's not about the Lord. It's about those who are going to celebrate the kingdom of the Antichrist. The Lord just reminded me of that right now. So, we are in the midnight hour. World War III is here at hand. Get your house in order. Prepare thyself to meet that God. Prepare yourself to meet that God. There's another Bible verse. Prepare to meet that God. Prepare to go out and meet Him. Be ready. Have your oil. Those who are in Christ do not slumber nor sleep. Wake up. Get up. Pray up. Pack up. Look up, because we're going up. Get ready to go up with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Be ready for Him to call your name. I believe He'll call each, we'll hear each hear our name. You know, we see in Revelation chapter 4, verse 1, we see with the two witnesses in Revelation chapter 11, we see where the command is given, come up here. I believe the Lord will tell us to come up here. And I believe just like when He called Lazarus out of the grave, He called him by name, Lazarus, come forth. I believe the Lord will say, Patrick, come up here. You know, and everyone will hear, come up here, but you will hear your name. If you are one of the wise virgins, if you are in the bride of Christ, if you are sealed and sanctified and filled with the Holy Ghost, you got to be, you know, that's a saying. You need to be truly born again. You need to make sure that you are truly, really born again, that you are in Christ at this hour. You know, I don't make it complicated. Just forget anything else I've said and just listen to this. Make sure that you are in Christ, that you are hidden in Christ tonight. Make sure. The Bible says, I've made a video, I mentioned this 100 times. You can talk in a circle and walk around the desert for 40 years if you want to in a circle. But Romans 8:16, it says, His Spirit, God's Spirit, the Holy Spirit, bears witness with our spirit. In other words, He speaks to us and confirms to us. His Spirit bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God, that we are sons of God. How do you know you're a child of God? Because you know, because the Holy Spirit bears witness to you. He confirms it to you. You know what those Bible verses are. Like Jesus said, God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whomsoever shall believe in who? Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son, shall not perish but have everlasting life. The Bible says all that call upon the name of the Lord will be saved. Now, to call upon the name of the Lord is not to say, hey, Jesus. It's to repent. And, you know, to call upon the name is an expression, to repent. Turn from your ways. You want to bet your eternal soul? You want to bet being left behind by believing these wacky, what do they call it, uber grace, ultra grace people out there saying you don't have to repent and all this stuff? Go for it. If you want to go in the rapture, you want to be there with the Lord, repent of your sin. Turn from your wicked ways. Turn from them. Ask the Lord to forgive you of your trespasses as you forgive those who have trespassed against you. Call upon the name of the Lord your God. Say, Lord, you know it's not a set prayer either. All that sinner's prayer stuff is just a guide. It's speak from your heart. Call out to Him while He is near, the Bible says. Call upon the Lord while He is near. Say, Lord Jesus, save me. I'm a sinner. I am lost. I'm separated from You. I don't deserve Your grace and mercy. I deserve to go to hell. I don't deserve to be in heaven. Lord, let me be forgiven, Lord. Thank You for making a way, not many ways, but one way for me to enter the kingdom of heaven. That's through Your sacrifice. Lord Jesus, You died in my place. For the Bible says the wages of sin is death. As God told Adam and Eve, when you eat the fruit, you'll surely die. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. I believe that is Romans 6:23. That's the only way, is through Jesus Christ. Roll your sin over on the Lord Jesus Christ and receive His righteousness today. Commit to Him. Follow Him. Turn not to the right or to the left. Do not deviate from following the Lord Jesus Christ. The hour is late. It's past. It is the midnight hour. It's just the Lord is about to call his bride. Come up here. Make sure you've got oil. Be filled with this Holy Spirit. Ask the Lord to fill you with the oil of his Holy Spirit. Get ready. Get ready. Forget the things of this world. You know, when I say that, of course, like we got the orphanage here. People doing ministry, go evangelize your neighbors and all that. Of course, we don't stop doing that. You know, we still have to eat. We still have to go to the bathroom. We still have to go to bed or whatever, all those things. Of course, get your heart out of the world. Like Lot's wife, don't look back. Flee sin. Flee the dead churches. Flee those dead churches that you're in. Flee false doctrine. Flee the world. Let your heart belong to Jesus and your body will follow. Even as the Lord said, the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Let your spirit man rule and reign. Stop being led by your flesh, as it says in Romans chapter 8, beginning at verse 1. Be led by the Spirit. Romans 8:14. Those who are led by the Spirit, these are the sons of God. Be led by His Spirit. Do not be ruled and reigned by your flesh. Do not walk according to the flesh, but walk according to the Spirit of God. I can't say it enough. I've tried to make a short video so I could get this loaded. This is a warning, warning, warning. And I don't know if this will be the last video I ever make. I mean, whatever. It's up to the Lord. Final warning. You know that when they're going to, if they have some EMP bomb and all this kind of stuff, internet's going to be wiped out. And the Lord even told me this at the same time he told me the other stuff. And I heard myself telling you guys, look, if the internet goes down tomorrow, just remember, you know, that your brothers and sisters in Christ are still out there. We still need to pray in unity. We still need to pray for their salvation. Pray for all of the people who you know. Continue to pray for me. I will continue to pray for you guys. Let's pray for each other. And then, I don't know how many days and how much we will see before the rapture happens. But we will not see, you know, the gross darkness and destruction coming with nuclear war and all that. And I do believe it's what I've heard before from the Lord, you know, that we'll see that a nuclear war begin and boom, we'll be out of here just as it's going down. And in my dream, several times I saw a nuclear explosion on the Korean Peninsula. So I assume we'll still be on Earth when that happens, maybe just as it detonates that it'll be time for the rapture. You know, lots of people have said when the bombs go down, we go up. You know, one person says it and then people keep repeating it. That may be true. I believe that's something like that. The War of Gog and Magog will be going and we'll go up as the War of Gog and Magog happens. I don't know. But just shortly afterwards, these people with all this clowning foolishness about the Psalm 83 war. I've said this before. There is no war in the Psalm 83. It's just a theory that somebody had that got solace. And he wrote a book about it, and that's awesome. But there's nowhere in the text does it say there's a war. There is, however, the War of Gog and Magog, Ezekiel 38 and 39. So God bless you guys. I don't want to get into, you know, to all these theology stuff. I just thought about it because, someone said because I didn't agree with that, and, you know, it makes you a false prophet if you don't agree. Well, there's a war in Psalm 83. Brothers and sisters, all of this foolishness is according to the flesh and not according to the spirit. Be ready to go. Let's get out of here. We're getting ready to go home. I myself am very weary. I know you guys are too, especially those who are really trying to walk in the spirit. Those who I talk to, I know you guys who are really trying to walk our Lord according to the spirit of God. Of course, we're weary. This world is so evil. This is, I posted an article on Facebook where in England they've been burning the aborted babies to heat the hospitals in England. And even, you know, all the atheists there are upset about it somewhat. I mean, why is it a problem to burn? If it's not a problem to abort them, why is it a problem to use them for fuel? I mean, that's the whole thing. And someone wrote in the comments and said if they'd been burning puppies, the people would be in an uproar. People love puppies more than they do babies, and that's true. That's another sign of this sick world that I see, you know, this animal lovers and animal rights activists. And the whole root of the animal rights movement is really that humans are no better than animals. And that's another way of the devil thumbing his nose at God's creation, whereas the Bible says man is created in the image of God. So when people start exalting Mother Earth and exalting Save the Whales and all this as somehow equal to humans, it's just another thing from the enemy to thumb the nose at that man is created in God's image. But I will add a disclaimer. Of course, I don't have anything against animals. Of course, I'm against animal cruelty. But when there's 50 million babies that's been aborted in the United States, saving the whales, it's not on my list of priorities. When what people keep talking junk about what Hitler did, as someone wrote in the comments on that article, they said Himmler was an amateur. And Himmler was, you know, as a propaganda minister for Hitler. Hitler has got nothing. There's only supposedly been 6 million Jews that were killed. And I think there was 8 or 9 million counting all the gypsies and all this stuff and everybody that Hitler killed. It's nothing compared to 50 million abortions in the United States. So it's really hypocritical for people to talk about Hitler and then accept what the United States does in England and other countries. It's all satanic, so evil. God bless you guys. I just mentioned some of these things that make us sick. Those of us who are trying to walk in the Spirit and follow the Lord, the sickness and vileness and vomit of this world, like Lady Gaga has someone vomit, green vomit on her while she's singing her song to the devil. Anyway, brothers and sisters, we're almost out of here. So God bless. So I'm giving you that message about World War III and all that. Get your house in order. But, you know, don't be afraid. You know, only be afraid of the Lord. You know, fear the Lord. As Jesus said, don't fear the one that can kill you, but fear the one that can throw you body and soul in hell. And that's, of course, the Lord is our judge. So fear the judge, the Lord, and don't fear man, fear World War III. Don't fear these things. Only fear the judge. That's the Lord. And work out your salvation with fear and trembling, the Bible says. Don't listen to these greasy gracers. Greasy gracers, if you comment on here and try to bring, you're just heaping condemnation on your own head. And I will block you because there's no way that I'm going to let you spew lies on my channel. And I don't let nobody spew their lies on my channel. They might block someone from getting saved because their ears enjoyed being tickled by your little lies that people don't need to repent. People can live like the devil and still go to heaven. May the Lord let you be held accountable for every person that you've told that lie to, unless you repent. So I call upon you, greasy gracers, to repent and go by what the Word of God says, not by your doctrine or what you've heard and your secondhand faith and secondhand knowledge. God has no grandchildren. Go back to the foundation and read the Word of God and read the words of Christ. Or even read the words of Paul. Go read the New Testament. I've made tons of videos on it. It says, you cannot do what you want. God forbid. God forbid we live in sin. It says, Peter said, be ye holy, for I am holy. He quoted from the Old Testament what God said. Without holiness, no man will see the Lord. God bless. I could go on and on all night, brothers and sisters. I hope to get this video uploaded. The internet's been real slow here. We're having lots of storms. There's also some electromagnetic stuff coming from the sun that I guess has been interfering with my internet connection the last day or two. God bless you guys. You know that I love you. And if the internet, like I said, when the internet goes down and there's World War III and all this kind of stuff, look up, pray up, pack up, look up, because we're going up. God bless you guys. Love you guys. I'll see you on the other side. If Lord returns before I'm allowed to make another video, I'll see you up there. And remember, we'll be singing "To God Be the Glory." Give Him the glory, great things He has done. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let the people rejoice. Let the earth hear His voice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let the people rejoice. Come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give Him the glory, great things He has done.